sucked. I don't want to be that guy. At the same time, I realized I'm not going to improvise my way out of this one. This is my speech. This is my story. And I'm sticking to it. So I walk up to the podium, arrange my ply gown. I smooth out my speech, and I laid it on them. And I said, I'd like to thank all of you young people for going to college, which sounds a little corny, so let me flesh out the point. I'd like to thank all of you for taking years of your life and devoting it to the pursuit of higher knowledge. And certainly not every single day of the last several years was devoted to the uploading of vast amounts of information to evolve your aptitude and your intellect. And that's why you were given hundreds of billions of brain cells so you could afford to maim, slaughter, suffocate, and otherwise kill hundreds of millions of them, as young people are wont to do as they run riotously up and down the hallways of academia, which the students understood to be youthful behavior that college students engage in, like cake parties and whatever else. So the students are like, "Wah!" And you know, so they're all having fun. The parents are like, "Does that mean we're smoking the pot? What the hell is going on in this place? It's a damn outrage, I tell you." And I said, "But by and large, in order for you to be sitting here today as a graduate, you had to apply yourself. And for that, I thank you. Now, several minutes from now, you're going to be holding a diploma in your hand. Please do not allow this diploma to be merely the means of some economic end that affords you some suburban box that allows you to buy things and put in the box and breed in that box and then go gently into that good night. You cannot be absorbed and disappear into the American consumerist cloth that easily or that anonymously. More is required from you in these very interesting and challenging times we live in. And so basically for the last several years, your job has been, by and large, to be a curious person. To wake up in the morning not satisfied with your intellectual quotient, only satiated at the end of the day, knowing more things than when you woke up in the morning. And just because you leave here today does not mean that you get a respite from your curiosity. Quite the opposite. Your curiosity is going to be like a flame that you're going to keep maintained and burning for the rest of your life. It's like a genetic trait you're going to pass down to your kids. It's like a virus with which you'll infect everyone you come into contact with. Why is the most important word in your vocabulary. You must keep asking the word why. You must keep asking questions. You must keep asking questions, pursue answers. You arrive at the answer, you catch your breath, you ask another question, and off you go in pursuit of another answer, relentlessly until you die. That is the only way it can be, because the world needs solutions to its many problems. Immediately, we need bluer skies. We need clear water. We need renewable energy. We need peaceful ways to resolve conflict. We have to come to the conclusion that all wars are preventable, no war is necessary, and that dropping white phosphorus on a bunch of people is not cannot be seen as progress or victory. It is an obscenity and must be stopped immediately by smart young people using peace as the prize, prosperity and technology and innovation to take this world forward. It's going to be you. I think that they're going to be teaching classes at the University of Sonoma here in Northern California hundreds of years from now about you all, that you were the ones who went out into the world and turned the entire thing around, that you were the ones who snatched victory from the jaws of defeat. And it sounds like I'm putting a lot of obligation and weight on your very young shoulders, and indeed I am. And I'm doing that because I know without a doubt in my mind that you are good for the task. And today is an amazing day, and your parents and me and all these teachers are glad to be here to witness it as you all start the future. Your hands are now on the wheel of the big bus. It is officially your world. I'm just going middle-aged in it, and I've seen the future. The future is very bright. It's you. Congratulations. Now go get them! And the students are wow, high-fiving each other, and no spears were thrown at my head. No one tried to kill me, and I realized I did not bomb all that badly. And you people lucked out. You got the Cliff Notes version. I gave them the three-page Turgid version that went on for just another minute and a half. But that was, in essence, what I told these people. I think that's what a young person should hear on his or her graduation day, that they have an obligation not only to themselves and their families, but an obligation to the world to make it better, using their youth, using their new education, and using all that vigor and desire for a more peaceful and prosperous planet. And I know that many of you have endured some of these awful talking experiences with me before. And perhaps some of you have come to the conclusion that a lot of my ideas are slathered in patchouli oil, keeping a hacky sack, looking for a tree to hug, and hoping that Jerry Garcia will magically rematerialize and take the great revenge of a mystical tour around the world. A lot of my ideas are hopelessly naive and utopian, and they very well could be, but I also think that possible. I don't know what the literacy rate is in the country of Holland. I don't know how many people you have graduate from college in your country. I can tell you, America is number 46 in literacy in the world. We have a dropout rate from high school, which is really appalling. That America is fairly dumb in relation to other industrialized countries should be the subliterate albatross swinging from America's collective neck. It should be our great shame. But many of us think it's cool to be stupid. I don't know shit! Ooh. You just admitted that in broad daylight? Wow, this country needs work. And so I know a lot of my ideas of hippy-dippy-doo, but for me it was a great day seeing all these young people with a diploma in their hand. And so I finished my speech, I walked back to my seat realizing I just kind of pulled it off, and I look at all the teachers and professors looking at me, and their faces are in disbelief, like, no! You did not just connect all those dots. And the faces in denial. No, that wasn't good. It was good, but I'm not going to admit it. Yet their hands were all applauding. It's like the hands were removed from the attitude of the face. The face goes, no. The hands go, oh, yes. And the face went, hands stop. And he's like, I don't know, that was pretty cool for a guy with tattoos. You got to admit, that one part made you tear up a little. And so the university president walks by me on his way to the podium. To go make the next announcement. And he looks at me and he says, I've been to about 20 of these, and that's one of the best ones I've ever heard. What the fuck? He was a total head scratcher. And he walked up to the microphone dumbfounded. I didn't see that one coming. Anyway, and immediately, that's when the best part of the day started, because you get to watch everyone graduate. And a student's name is called, the parents jump up and applaud wildly, and the young person walks up to the university president, gets the diploma, shakes the hand, stops for the photo, and then goes back to his or her seat. And quite often, someone would graduate and wait for someone else to graduate, so you go back to their seats together, arm in arm, and you see what a big day it is for these young people. So I turned into a one-man clapping machine. Right? As I clapped for all of them, like 110, going, ow, ow, ow. So I didn't want anyone looking up and see me not clapping. Like, yay, you not so much. But then, yeah! Because I was happy for all of them. I've never been to college, and I admire people who go. And obviously, you can get out of a college education without an education. Some of them become presidents. And so I do not know how your country is, and that I'm not here all the time. It seems to me that you are far less warlike than my country, which seems to want to shove the world around and shove democracy down people's throats and tell them how they're going to live their lives. It's just my hippy-dippy-doo-dot idea. If America put more of an emphasis on education, if we kind of hurled young people into places of higher learning and welcomed them into cages of higher learning, maybe we could get some results. And if I was president, I'd go there with my own presidential blowtorch.